Hi everyone, my name is Pierluigi, I'm a psychiatrist and I'm currently doing a PhD looking at the effect of antipsychotics on brain physiology. Antipsychotic treatments are often used to treat severe mental health disorders such as schizophrenia. However, although we know that these drugs are effective to treat these conditions, it is not entirely clear how the drug's target and the functional effect of the drugs are related. If we knew more about this relationship, we could have a better understanding of how these treatments work and why they can have varying effects in different people. In this research, we looked at the relationship between dose of antipsychotics, measure of regional cerebral blood flow as a robust measure of functional drug effect, and the drug's targeted receptor expression in the brain. I've analyzed data from a placebo-controlled study in healthy volunteers who received a single dose of three different antipsychotics. After the drug or placebo administration, we test the association of the main effect of the drugs, measured by cerebral blood flow, with target receptor distribution. Arterial spin labeling, ASL, cerebral blood flow data, was collected to monitor the functional effect. We also used positron emission tomography data with a tracer specific for the target receptors and postmortem microarray mRNA expression data from the Allen Brain Atlas, both to measure target receptor density in the brain. The cerebral blood flow measures was directly proportional to the density and the gene expression of the target receptors. The strength of the relationship varied with the different antipsychotic treatments, which could reflect different affinities for the target receptors across different treatments. These findings reinforce the use of MRI measures for cerebral blood flow as a robust in vivo marker of drug effects. We were able to show that quantitative measures of brain functional effect of antipsychotics are directly associated with receptor density measures. The characterization of the hemodynamic response using this multimodal approach might be applicable also on other classes of drugs, and it becomes particularly valuable for profiling compounds known to bind to multiple targets or with unknown or poorly characterized targets. Finally, our work demonstrates that the use of MRI 3D Picasso as a measure of regional cerebral blood flow offers an efficient, non-invasive tool to investigate CNS penetration in the process of psychotropic drug development that is also linked with brain chemistry. It's becoming clear that medicine is not one size fits all, and therefore it is important to consider individual genetic and other sources of variability in disease treatment and prevention. This work is important in bridging the gap between pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of novel and existing compounds, and it might be especially valuable for profiling the functional effect of drugs and understanding variability between subjects' response. That means that these results may also contribute to the development of personalized medicine in identifying which approaches will be effective for which patients. In general, it will lead to improved health outcomes for patients taking antipsychotic treatments. Thank you for watching.